brought to you by World Lightweight Championship, the world's largest bare-knuckle organization. It's a one super serious kickboxing match. The Tower of Power, El Bouni, in the black trunks. Khbabez wants to get on the inside, bridge the gap, stay in the pocket, work the body and the jaw. Stay close, stay glued to El Bouni. El Bouni will want to keep Khbabez at range with those long limbs of his.
El Bouni's throwing out that jab really nice and easy. Really slipping the guard. You can see Khbabez arching forward, throwing big shots.
El Bouni cuts away to the right ribcage. Then goes to the liver. Khbabez with a big right hand. Both men swinging the heavy artillery early. They know each other tremendously well. Two Dutch-Moroccans who have followed each other's careers closely now clash in one super series. Good leg check there from Khbabez. El Bouni gets clipped with an overhand left. Got to keep the clubs up, the counter-striking of Khbabez. He's awkward, but he's also fast. And he brings power, particularly with these four-ounce gloves. El Bouni backs off for the moment. Khbabez comes forward, hooks up both hands from Khbabez. El Bouni's got to get off the cage here, give himself some room. He eats a right hand from Khbabez. Misses with the outside leg kick. Does the thickly built Khbabez. If El Bouni wins, you'll see a fantastic celebratory dance from him. High knee from El Bouni. Fires the right hand off the cage. There's the left hook from Khbabez. And El Bouni shrugs him off. Oh, beautiful liver shot from El Bouni. And just upends himself. But that was a gorgeous liver shot off the left hand from Ibrahim El Bouni. Here he comes again. The Tower of Power controlling center cage. Now backs up a little. Thrusts the jab. Eats a left hook from Khbabez.
El Bouni is landing some beautiful counter shots. The way he's throwing that palm out there, and then he's reaching up, grabbing the head, pulling it down for a huge knee.
Khbabez, as mentioned earlier, continually comes forward on his opponents. 45 seconds remain in what has been a ferocious opening round. Step through knee from El Bouni. Jab. Jab two. Wild looping punches from Khbabez, missed the target. El Bouni slips the jab, fires one of his own. There's an overhand right from El Bouni. That uppercut went higher than Mike Delestro.
Good head movement from El Bouni. Just that constant pressure, though. He caught him in the left hand.
Beautiful left hand. And there's a right hand. El Bouni in trouble.
Bouni shoots it for a takedown. Wrong sport. Wrong rule set there from El Bouni. He tries a single leg.
It was smart from El Bouni. Mitch, he locked onto that single leg to avoid himself going down and getting a count. Gave himself a chance to recover because he was wobbled. He was tagged by Khbabez. What an opening round. It's one super series in Yangon, Myanmar. Tarik Khbabez and Ibrahim El Bouni.
Man, look at that big left hook. Caught him turning sideways. Caught him right on the chin. Caught him with an uppercut.
He held himself up. He held himself up.
Grabs the single leg there. One of those shots was so powerful it knocked the shoe off the referee. It was huge.
The size 11s flew off the feet of referee Atsushi Onari. What a contest. And look at that cut and mouse under the left eye of El Bouni. That's a ripper. My word, you can take that home as a souvenir. What a first round, Mitch!
Man, El Bouni was trying to counterpunch. He was trying to, you know, find that perfect range of countering those shots from Khbabez, but Khbabez just kept coming forward.
He's like a tank. He's like a human tank. He keeps rolling forward.
And no matter what El Bouni hit him with, Khbabez was not stopping, just rolling right through the village.
The village. Says Mitch Chilton. Here we go, second round. The first was an absolute rip snorter. What have they got in store for us here? It's a one super series kickboxing contest. Ibrahim El Bouni, Tarik Khbabez. Three judges are scoring on a 10-point must system, so you give the winner of the round 10 points, the loser of the round 9 points. Who do you think won the first? There's a nice short right hand from El Bouni. Similar right hand to what did the damage of Andre Mounier last time out. Overhand right from El Bouni, and left hook and a straight right hand from Khbabez. El Bouni's head is low, his chin exposed, and he ties up Khbabez for preservation.
Bouni can't get caught in those close round exchanges. He's got to keep that pressure away.
Oh, the body shot! The liver shot folds him in half! The liver shot folds him in half! And the mouth mouth guard came out of El Bouni. There'll be a caution there from referee Onari. It may have been a deliberate spin of the mouth guard to give him some breathing room, because he took a thunderous liver shot. Once that left hand drives up between the ribs, impacts the vagus nerve, it can close down the body in a hurry. And there's a standing count on Ibrahim El Bouni. Tarik Khbabez doing a number on El Bouni. How will the Tower of Power respond here? Khbabez oozing confidence out of every pore.
He's got to slow down that pressure. That tank is rolling through. He's got to utilize that jab, circle out. He can't get caught up there against the fence. That's where Khbabez does his best work.
Khbabez continually trying to get on the inside, trying to stay in the pocket. That's where he's most comfortable. El Bouni's got to keep him at range. Use the jab, use the front kick, the chin's down again. Second knockdown on El Bouni. One more in this round and it's over for El Bouni. Three knockdowns in one round is a TKO, but El Bouni bounds up by the count of 7 or 8. 1:05 remaining. Khbabez can smell a finish, perhaps. Left hand from Khbabez. Here's a house on fire here. Body shot almost lifts El Bouni off the canvas. He's going to go down again. No! El Bouni stays standing, but he may be right for the picking. He's right for the picking.
El Bouni's trying to bob and weave, but he can't. The punches just keep coming from Khbabez.
El Bouni, he's taken more shots than an alcoholic here in the second round. It's all one-way traffic. It's all Khbabez. But El Bouni's somehow still here. Ducks and weaves, each another left hand. The chin's going too low, and Khbabez is punishing him. Got to get off the cage here, El Bouni.
El Bouni going to make it.
Oh, another liver shot, another liver shot. That liver taking punishment now.
Khbabez hunting forward, looking for that big shot to end the night. The one-hitter quitter.
Final 10 seconds, Khbabez looking for the finish, looking for the knockout. And El Bouni may see out the round. He'll get some much-needed instruction. We are going to go into the third. It's all Tarik Khbabez. It's all the man with the powerhouse.
This is Khbabez at his finest. Looking forward to this. Look, closing the distance, negating that giant reach advantage. Coming in, looking for these short-range shots. El Bouni's got to keep his wits about him. He's got to keep his head moving. He can't stay stationary, because once he does, boom, he gets caught with those big, monstrous, lunchbox-sized hands of Khbabez, and he just unloads on El Bouni. He's got to keep moving. He's got to utilize the jab, maybe some push kicks. Just keep Khbabez away. He's got to unload.
This is one super series. If you're just a new viewer tonight, one super series is the striking arm of one championship. The best strikers of all styles on the planet are part of one super series. I'm talking Yodson Clay, Smoke and Joe Nutterwatt, Nicky Holtzkin recently signed, Giorgio Petrosian, Sam A. Gayangadao, Nongo Gayangadao, and a whole lot more megastars all on the one super series roster. Here we go, third and final round of what has been an absolute cracker.
I'm surprised we're seeing a third round, Michael.
This is Ibrahim El Bouni. You cannot write him off. And Khbabez in the pocket again. He could compete in a telephone booth. Khbabez comes forward, double forearms guard. Good right hand to the side of the jaw. Goes to the liver again.
It's that volume that Khbabez throws. It forces his opponents to retreat. They try to move their head. They try to bob and weave. But Khbabez just keeps hunting forward like that. He's constantly attacking. And he knocked the mouth guard out of El Bouni.
There were two knockdowns for Khbabez in the second round. Three knockdowns in the round, it would have been over. And you see that Khbabez continually attacking the liver, large organ in the upper right portion of the abdomen. It's a highly vascular area. A shot to the liver can be excruciatingly painful. It's about the size of a football. Mostly protected by the ribcage, but still slightly exposed. And if you turn the knuckles up, even between the 9th and 10th ribcage, you hit that vagus nerve, and that's what closes the body down on a good liver shot. And you see Khbabez go straight back to that liver. And there's a left hook. Khbabez having to weather another storm against the cage fence here. Got to get off the cage. Goes back to centering. Big outside leg kick from Khbabez. 2 minutes remain. What an absolute classic this has been. Left hook Khbabez, there's a straight right hand. Smack back between the eyes. El Bouni with the jab. Leads the right hand for company. There it is to the breadbasket. Belly button through the back. And again from El Bouni. Body shot from Khbabez. Hits El Bouni's damaged orbital. And referee Onari calls time. He's going to get a yellow card here, El Bouni. El Bouni receiving a yellow card from referee Onari. That will impact his perks. And continue here in the third and final. Khbabez, this monster, comes forward. Look how he tries to cut off the movement of El Bouni. How he forces El Bouni on the outside. He has done for the entire contest.
See, competing in the cage is not something, you know, Khbabez is used to. He's used to cornering people, backing up into the corner and then unloading on him. But this cage is giving El Bouni a lot of room to run, but now he's not.
Oh, El Bouni takes it off, the guy is in trouble now! El Bouni taking more knocks than a front door, but somehow he's still standing. El Bouni's now got out again. He could receive a caution here from referee Onari. It's usually a sign of fatigue. And you see, El Bouni takes a breather there. The corner of Khbabez is screaming out. El Bouni doesn't want to go on here. He's looking for a way out. But that's not in the nature of Ibrahim El Bouni. He comes home with a jab too. And here comes the powerhouse. Here comes Khbabez. Boom with the left hand. Look how he leans against the cage. El Bouni spent. El Bouni's done for here. He's right for the picking. That's over. That's a great stopping. That's a TKO. That's a knockout.
Khbabez putting on a show in Myanmar, calling for his shot at a one Super Series belt. Beautiful display of tenacity and toughness and just constant pressure from Tarik Khbabez. Look at this. Senses the momentary weakness, actually a long weakness from El Bouni, and just jumped all over him, just landing shots to the body, utilizing those giant hands, really putting the pressure on El Bouni. El Bouni was looking for a way out. Tarik Khbabez gave him that way out.
What a performance. Tarik Khbabez absolutely monstered Ibrahim El Bouni for three rounds. My word. Let's go to Dominic Lau.
To present the medal for this match, we have Dr. Sen Yolan, Director of Operations, World Lightweight Championship. And now, ladies and gentlemen, your referee, Mr. Atsushi Oh, called a stop to this contest after 2 minutes and 26 seconds in the third and final round for your winner by way of technical knockout, Tarik Khbabez!
Tarik Khbabez pulls off a shot in the kickboxing world. He says he wants gold around his waist.
Guys, it's Misha Tate. If you want to see more awesome ONE Championship content, make sure you click that subscribe button. Click it so you don't miss it.